The Lord said, I think thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me and I will answer you, and I will lead back your captives from every place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a scroll in the right hand of the one who sat on the throne. It had writing on both sides and was sealed with seven seals. Then I saw a mighty angel who proclaimed in a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the scroll and break its seals?" But no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth was able to open the scroll or to examine it. I shed many tears because no one was found worthy to open the scroll or to examine it. One of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, was triumphed, enabling him to open the scroll with its seven seals." Then I saw standing in the midst of the throne and the four living creatures and the elders a lamb that seemed to have been slain. He had seven horns and seven eyes. These are the seven spirits of God sent out into the whole world. He came and received the scroll from the right hand of the one who sat on the throne. When he took it, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb. Each of the elders held a harp and gold bowls filled with incense, which are the prayers of the holy ones. They sang a new hymn, "Worthy are you to receive the scroll and break open its seals. For you were slain with your blood, you purchased for God those from every tribe and tongue, people and nation. You made them a kingdom and priests for our God, and they will reign on earth." The word of the Lord. The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God. Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King. The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God. Let them praise his name in a festive dance. Let them sing praise to him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord loves his people, and he adores the lowly with victory. Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high priest of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all his faithful. Alleluia. The Lamb has made us a kingdom.
We're reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus drew near Jerusalem, he saw the city and wept over it, saying, "If this day you only knew what makes for peace, but now it is hidden from your eyes. For the days are coming upon you when your enemies will raise a palisade against you. They will encircle you and hem you in on all sides. They will smash you to the ground and your children within you. And they will not leave one stone upon another within you, because you did not recognize the time of your visitation." The Gospel of the Lord. I remember the story of a brother priest of mine who became a pastor for the first time many years ago. And he was being assigned to a parish where he is going to be following a pastor that has been in that parish for a very long time, and the people truly love that pastor. And they've had a certain way of dealing with things and a certain way of running that pastor that they've come accustomed to with a former pastor, that outgoing pastor. And so in this brother priest of mine, when he moved into that parish, a lot of the people met him at the end of his first mass, and they were congratulating him. And then a lot of them were saying to him, "Father, we will be praying for you because you have such big shoes to fill in," referring to the fact that this new priest is going to be following a pastor that has truly been loved, that's probably sent a giant or a celebrity in a particular parish. And so he would be hearing these comments over and over again from the people, "Father, you have such big shoes to fill." And so in response to all of these comments from the people, he said, "I appreciate that. That's why I brought my own shoes." And my brother priest was saying is that, yes, I understand that you have a certain way of doing things here. You have a certain way of dealing with things. But there are also other ways of accomplishing the same goals. There are also other ways of approaching the same issues, the same challenges. And I am aware of those things, and I'm going to apply those here too. I'm going to use those different ways. And therefore, it was this way of telling the people that not to be caught up in the way things were, in how they do things with a former pastor, because he would be doing things differently. And if they're not aware of that, then they might lose sight of the vision, or they might find themselves lost as the parish moves forward. But I think that idea, the principle, is something that kind of makes us reflect too. Because I think it's something that not only applies to pastors moving to parishes, but I think for all of us in life in general, but also most especially in our relationship with the Lord, where we tend to think that there's only a certain way of dealing with God, and there's only a certain way of praying, a certain way of making our petitions known or asking God to answer our prayers. But we all know that God is a God of surprises, and He always wants to surprise us. And more often than not, when He does things for us, when He gives us the things that we ask for, they're done not in the way we expect them to be, but sometimes in different ways. And that was the problem in our gospel this morning, is that the people always have a certain way of looking at who their Messiah is going to look like, of who his God is going to look like when He appears to them. And that's why they miss, or they fail to see, that the Son of God, the Messiah, is already with them, because they have a certain way of looking, not being open to what Jesus is revealing, which is something different than they're used to do. So I think it's a good way for us to be reminded today that, you know, first of all, the Lord loves to surprise us, and the Lord loves to be with us and encounter us in ways that we might not expect. And therefore, we should not be afraid to be surprised. We should not be afraid to sometimes be pulled out of a certain way of doing things so that we can encounter God. For truly, the Lord might visit us in a way that's unexpected, a way that we do not expect, but He will truly appear to us. And so, let us not be surprised, or let us not be afraid, rather, to be surprised by God when He comes to meet us. Let us bring to God our concerns and those of our brothers and sisters. For all leaders of the world, may they be a light in the darkness for all whom they serve. We pray to the Lord. For people who are disadvantaged in any way, we pray to the Lord. For those who are dying and who will face death today, that they may be guided to eternal life with God, we pray to the Lord. That through the intercession of Our Lady of Long Suffering, we will be spared all loss of life and property during this hurricane season, we pray to the Lord. And in silence, let us offer our own intentions. We pray to the Lord. Lord, listen to the prayers we bring to you today, spoken and unspoken, and answer them according to your will, through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, we pray that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end, holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending out your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Shelton, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. To those joining us from social media, please join me now in an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Remember, most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee do I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother, the Word incarnate, despise not my petition, but in thy mercy hear and answer me. Amen. O saluta, Christus hostia, quae celi pandis hostium, bella premunt hostilia, darobur fer auxilium, uni trino quae domino, sit sempi na gloria qui vitam si